Ladies and gentlemen, we had a back to back to back. Let's talk about it. Ladies and gentlemen, we had a back to back to back. So let's talk about it. So, 6-16 in LA. Kendrick was like, you got moles in your camp. I know the angles that you're taking. You're going to talk about my family. You're going to lie. And I already know that's what you're going to do. I'm giving you a chance to rethink it. Drake, being who he is, he released Family Matters. He made some accusations about Baby Keem writing for Kendrick. He also made some claims that Kendrick beats his wife and it had to hire a crisis manager for that. He also made some accusations that one of Kendrick's kids might not be his because his or fiance actually cheated on him with his best friend slash manager. And he accused Kendrick of being a fake gang member slash activist, depending on the day. And also, he said nigga multiple times in the song, which is kind of funny because Kendrick said, we don't want to hear you say nigga no more. So that was hilarious. Also in a Drake video, which was pretty smart to make a video for, to continue the, you know, the optics and the social media thing. Pretty smart on Drake's part. He had the everybody saying that Kendrick's best album is Good Kid, Mad City. So pretty much the whole video, he had that van similar to that being crushed, being on a tow truck and taken to a junkyard and being crushed, which was hilarious, I think. So 15 minutes after that, we had Meet the Grams. And Kendrick pretty much rebutted everything that was said in Family Matters. Very, very, very disrespectful. But the way the lines were delivered, it wasn't really in a disrespectful way. If that sounds weird, you just got to listen to the track. So pretty much what he said was, I know the angles that you were going. You got a mole in your camp. Here's your Ozempic prescription. Here's your prescription for the perks and everything that you pop because you are a drug addict. You have pedophiles on your payroll and you have your children around there. And he pretty much had a therapy session with Adonis, which is Drake's child. He also had a conversation in a song with Drake's mother, Sandra. He had a conversation with Dennis Graham, which is Drake's father, and saying that he blames him for the way that Drake is acting and the way that Drake is parading his father around to claim his blackness when it suits him, which is the angle that Kendrick has been taking. And I guess the reveal was saying that Drake has another daughter, well, another child out there that he is possibly, he doesn't really know about because he's saying that he's a sex addict. He pays for escorts and these escorts are having his children. This is really good for rap. I think so. And I said something maybe 2 or 3 podcasts ago where I said that I don't think this is going to get violent. I hope I'm right that it doesn't get violent. But the things that are being said is very, very distasteful and disrespectful on both sides. Yes, I'm a Kendrick fan. I'm a Drake fan. But I'm team Kendrick all day and every day. And sometimes the little accusations, the little shots, it's hip hop. But when you hit personal like this, like Kendrick is doing, it gets a little, the waters get a little murky and things are getting really disrespectful. So I hope nobody crashes out on either side as far as their camps. Because, you know, usually in hip-hop beef, the main artists don't get hurt. Their entourages are the ones that get hurt. So, this has been a very interesting day. I don't think anything like this have happened in a very long time. Like, back to back to back like this. Like, literally 15 minutes after one person releases something. Like, I think Ross was probably like 2 hours after Drake released Push Ups. But this is less than an hour. This is less than 30 minutes that Kendrick put out Meet the Grams after Drake put out Family Matters. So, yeah, this is, it's entertaining. It is. But I think fans are looking at who's revealing the most tea, who's the most disrespectful. I don't think either side has really proven anything, really. Because being objective, speaking objectively, those things that Kendrick had, I mean, you could really make any type of label on a computer nowadays. And as far as Drake, you could say anything and your fans are going to eat it up. So just taking my biases out of it, I don't think each side, I think each side has to prove what they're saying. I don't think either side has really proved anything. If you're looking at it that way. So we shall see what happens. Yeah. Well, this has been another episode of the Mitchell Hour Podcast. Until next time, I'm out.
Thank you for tuning in. Hit that like button, comment, and subscribe. And until then,